Okay, look at this. Sahih Bukhari. Okay, we're going to Bukhari again. This is Hadith. Okay. Narrated by Abu Huraira, the father of kittens, the father of cats. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi said, I have to clean my screen now. If a man invites his wife to sleep with him and she refuses to come to him, then the angels send their curses on her till morning. What wonderful lessons to teach girls about how to become proper wives when they grow up. Is this not promotion of the R word? Like, this is like not just, you know, ignoring consent. This is like you cannot not consent. Like, you have to accept. Yeah, no is not an option. This is basically saying no is not an option. Yeah, exactly. Devon is saying, what the fuck is this? But guys, I'm going to read this hadith one more time for the people at the back. If you didn't hear me reading this the first time. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi said, if a man invites his wife to sleep with him and she refuses to come to him, the angels send their curses on her till morning. And if that wasn't enough, if Sahih Bukhari, maybe Bukhari made a mistake. Well, is it? Another authentic source of hadith saying pretty much the same thing, Sahih Muslim. So the two main books of Islamic hadith, the two pillars of Sunnah, Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, basically say the same thing. So multiple chain of narration and all that crap, it all is verified, okay? And it says, oh, look, it's Abu Huraira. So it confirms even the chain of narration, okay? Abu Huraira, Allah be pleased with him, reported that Allah's apostle sallallahu alayhi said, when a woman spends the night away from the bed of her husband, the angels curse her until morning. Very similar to this other hadith that we just looked at, right?